Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Susan Brown, Director of the Center for Better Bones, and today I want to talk just a minute about this bone density testing and suggest to you that there's a very important test your doctor had missed. If you're concerned about bone health, you've probably had a bone density test. And it's possible that your doctor told you, hey, you've got the bones of an 80-year-old, or you're going to fracture, or I've seen people been told by their doctor that they're going to end up in wheelchairs if they don't take bone drugs. Bone density tests are often used as kind of a weapon against us in a certain sense. Many women are scared, and I'm here today to move you from being frightened to being empowered. These bone density tests have many limitations, and it's good to know them. Number one, they're more of an aerial measurement than a density measurement. They do not exactly measure bone density at all. They're very influenced by area, size of bone. So smaller bone people and thin people get much lower readings. That's really important because there's a direct linear relationship between body weight and bone density. Many thin women in particular become extremely frightened by these reports. It does not measure density. Number two, bone density testing does not predict fracture very well. And this is being widely accepted, and it can be easily understood if you look at the fact that 70-80% of all fractures occur in people who do not have a bone density that would be called osteoporotic by the bone density testing. These fractures occur in individuals who either have osteopenia, which is considered a much lower amount of bone loss, or even 20% of all fractures occur in people who have normal bone density. So these bone density tests do not predict fracture, and don't be scared into thinking they're going to predict fracture. We never like to see ongoing excessive loss, and we're going to talk about a new test that can help you gauge your amount of loss, but bone density tests themselves cannot predict fracture. And then it's extremely important to know that these tests detect just one moment in time. They take a shot of one moment when your bone looked like at that time. The earlier test might have been done years before. This might be your first test, but it's just one shot in time. In order to predict fracture, you need to get the big picture on bone health, and you need to look at multiple risk factors. You need to look at all the factors that are depleting bone, from vitamin D to the drugs you take. Finally, remember that bone density is not the same as bone strength. And while one day scientists will develop a way to detect bone strength, we don't have one now. And bone density is often presented as representing bone strength, but it really doesn't. To really predict fracture, you need to look at multiple risk factors, one, and you also need to know the current rate of bone breakdown. Are you losing too much bone at this particular time? There is a test for this, and this is what I want to talk with you about just for a minute. There is a test of bone breakdown. There's actually a couple tests. The one I really like is called the NTx, the N-Telopeptide. Now, this can be a simple urine test or a simple blood test that can tell you how much bone you're losing right now. Your bone density may show you lost a lot of bone between 50 and 55, but our question is, what is happening right now? As it turns out, bone is very much like a sponge upon which minerals sit. That sponge is made of protein. When you lose bone, that protein sponge shows up in the urine. These are called N-telopeptides, and they can be measured in the urine or the blood. And you can distinguish whether the person has a high rate of bone loss or really a low rate of bone loss. It's an inexpensive test. You can even, in most states, order it yourself online, and you can certainly ask your doctor to order it. We have much information about this test. It's a simple, wonderful test to detect how much bone you're losing right now. It's non-invasive. It doesn't cost very much. And it can tell you if you're undergoing a period of rapid bone loss. And actually, using this test, I've discovered something very important that has not been mentioned before, but there are different types of osteoporosis. And we've discovered that there's some osteoporosis where people are actually breaking down very little bone, but still losing bone. We recommend that people always get a bone breakdown marker so that we can see what their level was when they came to our program, when they started using the Better Bones Builder or their bone supplements, and how they change that rate of bone breakdown with the supplements. And in fact, this test was actually developed to see if the drugs were working, because these bone drugs halt bone breakdown. And so this was a simple way to say, is this drug working? It can also be used very effectively to say, am I losing bone right now? And number two, is my therapy that I'm doing, are my nutrients, is my builder program being successful? Am I reaching the levels I want to get? So what I want to say, take heart and take action. There are many wonderful tools beyond bone density testing and better than bone density testing that you can use to enhance your bone health. Be well. I wish you lifelong bone strength.